Have you previously played King's Quest V?
Hey everyone, and welcome back to another playthrough of King's Quest V: Absence Makes the Heart Go Yonder. Finally.
Warning, this cartoon contains material that may be necessary for information or clues to complete this game. Please be sure to check your inventory if you decide to skip.
All right, fine. I guess we gotta watch it, so let's just jump right into the game, shall we? Oh, it's Castle Daventry. I think that's where King Graham lives. I'm pretty certain. I don't know who this guy is. Oh, sh. Uh-oh. What are you doing? Who are you? Wait, is it Mananan? Did he come back? What? Where'd the castle go? Hey, this reminds me of Robin Hood, Men in Tights. You know, when his castle, gets taken. Oh, look at this. So this game is gonna be like a lot better because obviously there's voice actors in here, so I don't have to read anything out loud for you and you guys. I know how much you guys love my voice. Oh, Graham. Get flowers for his wife. You're in for a surprise, Graham. Mr. Adventurer. Yeah. So I'm pretty excited to play this game. Every game I'm like, I'm pretty excited to play. But for this one, it's getting to the end. It's getting to the last game. And I can't wait for that. Oh. Oh no, Graham. Gasp.
My castle? What has happened?
I don't know. Oh. Mr. Owl.
Ooh, I can tell you what happened. What?
Or, tell me. Nice shot.
Ooh, I know what happened to your castle. I saw it all. Yes, I did.
You did? Well then, what happened?
You didn't do anything. You just sat there in a tree. Freaking owl.
Oh, it was the powerful and evil wizard Mordak who did it. Oh, I just happened to be visiting with an old friend when I saw him materialize out of thin air. Thank goodness he didn't notice me.
Well, don't stop now. Go on.
He's a mole rat.
He conjured up a terrible whirlwind that swirled faster and faster around the castle. With another incantation, Mordak then caused the wind to draw the castle up into the sky and out of sight. Ooh, it was something to see, all right.
That voice, though.
Why? Why would this wizard, Mordak, want my castle? What could he have against me and my family?
That I don't know. Ooh, I only know that it was Mordak who took your castle and your family. Well, perhaps I can help you. My employer also happens to be a wizard, which is why I recognized Mordak. Ooh, unlike Mordak, though, my employer is a very good wizard. His name is Crispin Arthur, but we all call him Crispin for short.
Crispin?
The only problem is, you see...
Oh, snap. Relax. Oh, God. Oh, boy. Grandma's, like, not impressed. He's like, what the hell's the matter with this bird?
Anyway, where was I? Oh, yes. The only problem is that Crispin is getting on in years and tends to be a bit forgetful.
I don't know. This doesn't sound as if it would work.
Oh, sure it would. Crispin is a very qualified wizard. One of the best. He just gets a little forgetful now and again. That's all. Now, where is it? Oh, I know I brought it with me.
Probably dropped it.
Here it is.
What is that?
Well, it is my opinion that you don't stand a chance against the likes of Mordak. Ooh, excuse me for saying, Your Majesty, but you don't have a choice. You must come with me. I'm sure Crispin can help you.
This is King Graham you're talking to. He beat a dragon. Oh, what are you doing?
What is that stuff?
Just some old leftover fairy dust I've been carrying around. It'll help you to fly.
Ooh.
You can follow me to the land of Serenia, where Crispin and I live. It's much too far to walk, you know. Ooh, I think the fairy dust is still good.
Yeah, well, I hope so. Alright, Graham. Flap your arms. Let's get out of here. Let's go see this Crispin guy.
Come on!
Oh snap. Oh. Graham. If we can pull it together. Jeez. Well then. Well, this is a new adventure. Yeah, there you go, Graham. You're doing it. You're flying! Like Peter Pan. Okay. Where are we? Oh, there we are.
There it is! Down here! Come on!
Okay. Here I come!
Dive bomb! Oh shit! Oh god, Graham. Careful. Hope he lands in the water. Oh, there. Smooth landing.
Ooh, looks like the fairy dust just wore off.
Nice landing. What's going on out here?
Cedric? Where have you been? I've been calling for you.
He's like, that guy.
Well, well. What have we here?
A strapping young lad. It's Herbert the pervert.
A bit clumsy, are you? Well, come on in the house and dry off. No sense sitting around like a wet dog.
Do you know who you're talking to?
Cedric, go into the house and pour each of us a nice hot cup of tea.
Ooh, aye aye, Crispin.
Society of Wizards has always taken a dim view of Mordak and his abuse of his power. Why, he's even been put on suspension a few times. It never seems to do any good, though.
Crispin, why would Mordak want to take my family or castle? What did we ever do to him?
I'm afraid I don't know the answer to that. Mordak is a very unpredictable wizard. I've never understood that evil mind of his.
Ooh. I thought perhaps you could help His Majesty, Crispin. That's why I brought him here.
Well, let me see now.
But you just...
I used to be a very powerful wizard at one time, you know. But I've gotten a little rusty lately.
You mean old?
A little rusty?
Oh.
That's quite enough from you, Cedric.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, sir, Crispin, sir.
He's like, hoo-hoo, you're old.
I don't know what I have that would be of much use to you. Most of my wizard stuff is pretty old and worn out. But let's see what I can find.
Oh, jeez. Any day there. You want me to get it for you? You need like... 10 hours later. Lift with your legs. Huh.
No, that won't do. That's all used up. It might work. Here, eat this.
Oh, Graham.
What is that?
magical white snake I had left over from last year.
Oh, thanks.
With it, you'll be able to communicate with the natural and animal world. You could find that quite helpful.
But that's very tasty, though.
Here's my old wand. I don't even know if it works anymore.
Well, thanks.
Most of its power may be gone. You should know that wands are like pets. They've got to get to know you before they'll work for you. Just treat it with care and respect, and hopefully it will do something for you.
Thanks.
You'd better get going, my boy. No telling what that confounded Morak could be up to. You go with him, Cedric. Show him the way. Yes, you. Don't be such a coward. Now go on. You'd better get started.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate all you've done for me.
All right, let's head out. Goodbye, wizard. He just wanted to get rid of some of his clutter in his house.
First. How about it, Your Majesty?
Ooh, okay.
Please don't call me Your Majesty, Cedric. It's much too formal. I'd like it if you'd just call me Graham.
Graham.
Ooh, I'd be delighted to, Graham. Anyway, what was I talking about? Oh, yes, the town. You might be able to find some supplies there. It's just over a little hill to the south, not too far.
Well then, let's be on our way, Cedric.
All right, let's... What the... I guess that's how you... That's so weird. Oh, I can use my mouse. I don't have to use the keyboard anymore. All you hear... All you're gonna have to hear...
Graham, watch out! A poisonous snake!
A poisonous snake! Where? Where's the snake? Oh, it's over here. I didn't even see him. Oh well. Let's be on an adventure. Boop-a-doo. Yay, we get to play as King Graham again. I think this is the last time we get to play as him, actually. I'm sad. Is that a goat? That's a nice... Looks like a nice, lovely town. I wonder if we can speed up. No, I don't think we can do much of anything like that. Oh.
If you're going into town, I'll just wait for you here.
Right.
I had a nasty run-in with a big dog once, and I feel much safer out here.
Okay. Alright. I'm not sure what to do. There's a lot of noise going on. And we're gonna go talk to this guy, I guess.
How goes it with you, little fellow?
Not well, I'm afraid. This old wagon's always giving me trouble.
Can I help you in any way?
Thank you kindly, but I think I can handle it.
Alright then, good luck.
Thanks. With this wagon, I'm gonna need it.
She's like... Graham doesn't even, like, insist. He's just like, alright then, whatever. Alright, so... That was interesting. What was this? Taylor. Okay, let's go in here. Man, there's a lot of noise going on. Oh, hello. I'm gonna cover that up.
This, may I help you, sir?
I'm interested in buying something here.
Ah, let me show you some things. A fine piece of cloth. With this material, I could make you beautiful shirts. There isn't a more beautiful piece of fabric to be found anywhere. With this, I could make you the finest trousers you've ever had. Well, what do you think?
Well, right now I'm just looking. Thanks anyway.
Sure, sure. Whatever you say, I'm just here to help.
I like how he walks too. Very dainty.
I don't like this at all.
Alright, jeez. Okay, bye. Oh. What is this?
Graham notices a shiny silver coin lying forgotten on the street near the...
Alright, cool. We're gonna go grab it.
Bending down, Graham quickly retrieves the silver coin from the street.
Okay, Graham. First of all, you're a king. You have gold up the U-Haw, and you need to pick up a freaking gold silver piece on the street.
May I help you, sir?
Makes no sense.
Not wishing to be put through another speech about fine shirts and trousers, Graham wisely keeps his mouth shut. In the corner of the shop, draped casually over a tailor's form, Graham sees a thick, fur-lined cloak.
Oh, I thought we were going to be able to, like, buy something with the silver coin, but I guess not, so let's keep going. Alright.
Graham notices an old wooden barrel on the street corner.
I guess...
The people are too caught up in their own business to pay much attention to Graham.
He's a king! Like, no one recognizes him.
Inside the barrel, Graham sees an old, rotting fish.
Take the fish.
Graham leans way down into the barrel and removes, phew, the smelly old fish.
Alright, we're gonna keep going. Busy town. Okay. Ah, okay, there's another house over here. Watch out, has poisonous snake.
Cedric keeps an eye on Graham near the town bakehouse.
Interesting. Look at his little Graham. Da, la, la, la. Go inside.
Ooh, I'll wait for you here, Graham.
Okay, go ahead. Whatever. Go there.
And how is your poor dear mother doing, William?
Oh, she hasn't been doing too well lately. But my brother and I help out whenever we can. Thanks for asking, Amanda.
Austin, keep your fingers out of that pie. Pies look lovely. I think I'll take one.
Yes, they were just made fresh this morning. Here you go.
Yes, this will be a fine dessert for our dinner tonight. Let's go home, Austin.
It was Austin. I thought she said Ahmed. I was like, that's kind of okay. Hey, crown. La 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 la. He's a king now.
Here's the last of the pies.
Nice.
Welcome to our bakehouse, traveler. Of course, all of our wares are wonderful, but today we've got a special on custard pie. Just one silver coin each, but take your time. Let me know when you're ready.
Well, I'm ready. I'm ready for that pie.
Everything looks so delicious, it's hard to decide what to buy.
Everybody has that problem, but what a problem to have.
Those custard pies look most delicious.
Yes, they're made from a recipe handed down from our dear mama and her mama before her.
Dear mama?
It's still hard to decide, though.
Just pick one.
Well, take your time. There's no hurry.
Jeez, Graham. You could literally take any pie. Just say, like, I'm the king.
The baker bides his time behind the counter, while Graham looks hungrily at all the delicious wares.
I guess I'll take that one.
Would you like a pie, sir?
Yes, because that's all you have.
Well, yes, actually, I would.
That'll be one silver coin, then.
Let me see if I have one.
You do, you do.
Well, let me know if you do.
You just picked one up.
Graham would love to buy a pie if he could. Graham would love to buy a pie. pie if he could.
He does. You can.
Graham waits to further bother the baker. The baker, a large, sturdy fellow, waits for customers behind a pie-covered counter.
The wait cursor will appear on the screen anytime the game is at a stage where it will not respond to any of your commands. The hold cursor will appear on the screen.
Inventory. How do I choose my inventory?
The wonderful smells of the bakehouse set Graham's stomach to rumbling and his mouth to watering.
I don't know how to look into my... Oh, there we go. Here's a silver coin. Okay. There you go.
Sir, I would like to purchase one of your custard pies.
I don't remember how I did that.
These pies cost one silver coin each.
Yeah, I have one right here.
I've got it right here.
There
you go.
I hope you enjoy your custard pie.
Oh, I'm sure I will.
Oh, I will. Thank you very much. Now, let's go. I'm not really sure what we're doing now. I guess we'll keep going this way. Ooh. Actually, let's look at this. Swarthy Hog Inn. Okay. Let's not do that yet. Oh, snap.
Ooh, watch out for the bear, Graham.
I think you better watch out for the bear. You're just sitting right there. Holy crap. Okay. I get the fish. I give the fish to the bear. Goodbye. Oh, God.
I'm Queen Beatrice, kind sir. I wish to thank you ever so much for saving our hive from the claws of that horrible bear.
You're welcome.
In return, I offer you a luscious honeycomb from our hive. Please feel free to retrieve one. I promise my bees won't harm you. It may come in handy on your travels.
Well, thank you kindly. I get to pick up a stick.
Graham bends down and picks up the large stick from the ground.
I will grab some honey. Honeycomb.
Graham reaches a hand into the beehive and retrieves a very sticky chunk of honeycomb. Wrapping it in a protective piece of cloth, he then pockets it.
Nice. All right. That's awesome. Now, I guess...
Cedric seems to be quietly contemplating their current situation, and so is not inclined to indulge in conversation right now.
Fine then. Oh jeez. Oh jeez. Dog.
A bully of a dog terrorizes the poor ants as he playfully digs at their large anthill. The dog is more interested in the anthill than in Graham.
You little jerk. Oh. We have a stick. And I can give the stick to the dog. Go grab it. You jerk dog.
Allow me to introduce myself. I'm King Anthony the Great. May I ask who you are?
I'm King Graham.
Why, certainly. I'm King Graham of Daventry, and this is my friend, Cedric.
That's right.
We're seeking a way to cross the Great Mountains to the ocean on the other side.
That is a very perilous undertaking. I wish you would reconsider. But if you shall not, in return for rescuing our home from that grievous incur, I wish to offer you our help, if perchance you may ever need it.
Thank you very much, King Antony. Cedric and I appreciate your kind offer. We look forward to meeting you again.
King Antony, I love it. Oh, that's cute. They like the ant song, the marching, right?
Is that there's nothing but a hot, dry desert further west. Most people avoid it because there are bandits out there. Ooh, if you insist on going, I'll wait for you here.
You know, Crispin told you to stay with me. but yet you're being a coward. Alright guys, so I think I'm going to end the episode here. I hope you enjoyed this episode. It was mostly backstory, I guess you would say. Not really backstory, just like explaining the adventures of Graham. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this episode, and please give it a like if you did, and subscribe if you haven't done so already. And I will see you in the next episode. Bye!